Tonight, the New York Times reporting that there is a confidential document, a document which shows that Trump administration claims about a Russian oligarch and Putin confidant at the center of the Russia investigation are not true. It's a confidential binding document that, according to the Times, lays out a deal between Oleg Deripaska and Trump's Treasury Department, a deal which relieves Deripaska from hundreds of millions of dollars in debt and allows Deripaska and his allies to keep majority ownership of his most important company. Now, this is stunning, and it's crucial. And it's not just stunning because Deripaska is central to the Russia investigation. It is stunning because when Trump's Treasury Secretary, Steve Mnuchin, announced the sanctions were being lifted on Deripaska, to the shock of many, he put out a statement saying that Deripaska was losing control of his company. That was the whole justification. He said, quote, "These entities are undergoing significant restructuring and governance changes that sever Deripaska's control." And again, according to the New York Times, confidential document would show that that is not true, begging the question, why? And as we ask that question, it comes as President Trump's lawyer, Rudy Giuliani, is again trying to change the timeline on how long President Trump was personally working on a major deal in Moscow during the campaign, a deal that involved Putin. Giuliani quoting Trump himself to the New York Times, saying the talks were, quote, "going on from the day I announced to the day I won." So Giuliani sharing that as a quote from the president to the Times. It's a point that Giuliani also emphasized in two interviews over this weekend.
In his written answers, President Trump's written answers to special counsel Robert Mueller's questions, what did President Trump have to say about the Trump-Moscow project?
He acknowledged that they had conversations about it throughout 2015, 2016. But the president can remember having conversations with him about it.
Throughout 2016.
The president also remembered. Yeah, probably up to, could be up to as far as October, November.
Okay, look, this is really significant because dates matter a whole lot when it comes to relations with Russia during the campaign. What this means, what Rudy Giuliani just did there, was admit that talks lasted much longer than previously believed. Now, according to court documents, Michael Cohen said they stopped on June 14th, 2016, and that shocked everybody because that was after everybody had lied and said that they stopped before the primaries even began. All right, so first it was the beginning of the year with primaries, and then it was June 14th. And now, Giuliani is admitting that talks went through the entire election, which proves that all of this was false.
I know nothing about the inner workings of Russia. I don't deal there. I have no businesses there.
I don't know Putin. Have no business whatsoever with Russia. Have nothing to do with Russia.
I have nothing to do with Russia, Fud. They said, maybe Donald Trump is involved in projects with the Russian. The answer is no. No.
Okay. So not only is all that not true, but if Trump was continuing to push a major project in Moscow through the election, it puts a whole new light on these sorts of comments.
Russia, if you're listening, I hope you're able to find the 30,000 emails that are missing.
You know, the people of Crimea, from what I've heard, would rather be with Russia than where they were.
I hope I like him. I hope he likes me. Because I'd love to get along with Russia, okay?
Sure would, right? I mean, there was a lot of money at stake, especially if you didn't think you were going to win the White House, which he didn't. And Giuliani tonight desperately trying to do cleanup, telling CNN that his statements that Trump and Michael Cohen were talking about Trump Tower in Moscow up until the election were hypothetical and not actually based on real conversations with the president. Okay, the problem is, let me remind you from what I just said a moment ago, is that does not add up because recall Giuliani quoted Trump. He quoted Trump to the New York Times. He didn't hypothetically say maybe what Trump thought. He quoted him saying that the president told him that talks were, quote, "going on from the day I announced to the day I won," a quote from the president.